हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन सोशल साइंस क्लासेस क्लास 10th एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ ज्योग्राफी पार्ट एग्रीकल्चर। एज वी नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड 2 मॉड्यूल्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड दिस इज़ द 3rd मॉड्यूल ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। इन प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न और सीजन इन इंडिया। Today, in module number 3 or part 3, we are going to discuss about the different crops, whether food crops, fiber crops, and plantation crop.
So let's start the topic. First and the most important food crop is rice, followed by the wheat and other crops. Food, if we talk about the main or the staple food, rice is the staple food of majority of people in India. This is the second largest producer in the world after the China. India stands on second position after the China in the production of rice. Rice is a kharif crop which require, if we talk about the temperature, so about 25 degree temperature and high humidity with annual rainfall of above 100 centimeter. These are the climatic condition for the rice, as well as it grows in the plain area of north and northeastern India, coastal regions and the deltic region. So these are the area for the rice. Development of dense network of canal irrigation and tubewells have made it possible to grow rice in area of less rainfall like Punjab, Haryana and Western UP and some part of Rajasthan also.
Due to, as you know, that rice require a lot of water, but due to the network of irrigation, network of canal irrigation in Punjab, Haryana and Western UP, it is possible to grow more rice.
After rice, the second crop, this is the wheat. Wheat is the second most important cereal crop. For North India, if we talk about, so for North India, wheat is a staple crop, North as well as Northwestern part of the country. If we talk about the climatic condition for the wheat, so it requires cool growing season and bright sunshine at the ripen time. It means, as we have already discussed, that wheat is a rabi crop, and rabi, they are winter crop. So when the seed showing of wheat, there is a requirement of cool season. So this is winter season, and it harvest at the time of sunshine, bright sunshine. So at the ripen time, it require bright sunshine. That's why it is a rabi crop, which grows in October, November and cut in March, April. It require 50 to 75 centimeter of annual rainfall. When we see, rice require above than 100 centimeter, but wheat require only 50 to 75 centimeter of annual rainfall and evenly distributed over the growing season, and in entire season it was required. Important wheat growing zones: Ganga, Satluj plain, because there is a fertile area of alluvial soil, and black soil region in Deccan Plateau. Major wheat producing state: Punjab, Haryana. Punjab, Haryana and Western UP, these states called as granaries of India, because wheat, rice or so many other crops grown in these area maximum. Except these three states, Bihar, Rajasthan and some part of MP also grow the wheats in high producing states. After wheat, as you can see the area of wheat also, the major and minor area for the wheat. After wheat, there is a millets. Millets called as coarser grains. In this way, you can see millets include ragi, jawar and bajra. So it includes coarser grains, mean different kind of grains, small grains large grains they include and called as millets. Jowar, bajra and ragi are the important millets grown in India. Though these are known as coarser grains, as I told you, small, huge, there are different sizes of the grains, that's why they called as coarser grains. They have high nutrition value. Ragi rich in iron, calcium, other micronutrients and roughage. It is a crop of dry region and grow well on red, black, sandy, loamy and shallow soils. Karnataka is the largest producer, followed by Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand and Arunachal Pradesh. Also important for the ragi production. Jowar is the third most important food crop with respect to the area and production. It is rain fed means it get water from only the rain. Grown in moist area, Maharashtra is the largest producer of the jowar, followed by Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and MP, Madhya Pradesh. So rabi, jowar, bajra. Then third one is bajra. Grow well on sandy soil and shallow black soil. Rajasthan is the largest producer for the bajra, followed by UP, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana. These are the major states for the millets production. Next is pulses. Pulses are very important because they are highly nutritious and a great source for the proteins. In India, the largest producer as well as consumer of pulses in India. India is the largest producer as well as consumer in the entire world. These are the major source for protein in vegetarian diet, as explained you. Major pulse grown in India are tuvar, arhar, urad, moong, masoor, peas and gram. Pulses need less moisture and they survive even the dry condition also. So these are very important for India like country where there is an uncertainty of the monsoon and unavailability of the good irrigation system. So all these crops except arhar help in restoring soil fertility by fixing nitrogen from the air, because of which is grown in rotation with the other crop. As you know, for the nitrogen fixation there is a need of rhizobium, which found in the nodes of pulses, but in arhar there is no foundation or there is no availability of these rhizobium bacteria. So except arhar means in arhar there is no formation of the nitrogen fixation. Except arhar, rest of the pulses are very important for the fixation of nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen. Major pulse producing state in India are MP, UP, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. So these are the important state for the production of pulses in India. Sugarcane. Sugarcane is also very important and it is related to our day-to-day life. As you know, from sugarcane we produce sugar in the industries. So it is a tropical as well as subtropical crop. Sugarcane is a tropical as well as a subtropical crop. Climatic condition for the sugarcane, it grow well in hot and humid climate. So it required humid also, with a temperature of 21 to 27 degrees. An annual rainfall required from 75 to 100 centimeter. So in this way we can say rice require above than 100, wheat required 50 to 75 and sugarcane requires 75 to 100 centimeter rainfall annually. It can be grown on variety of soil, need manual labor from sowing to harvesting. Sugarcane is also called as annual crop because it required about 1 year for the growing and ripening. India is the second largest production after the Brazil. Main source of sugar, jaggery, khandsari and molasses. Major sugar producing state UP, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Punjab and Haryana. These are the important sugar cane producing states. When we talk about the different types of farming in India, intensive, subsistence, we can subsistence divide in two part, primitive and intensive and commercial. But there is another type of farming which is included in commercial. This is known as a plantation agriculture. Means the characteristics like large land or the yield, capital intensive, skilled labor, all these are the requirements same as the commercial farming. So plantation is a type of commercial farming. It is a type of commercial farming, and it is a type of farming in which a single crop is grown on a large area. So we can say that plantation, in plantation there is a monoculture. Monoculture means only one crop grown on a large area. Plantation has an interference of agriculture and industry. It means, suppose like tea. Tea is a plantation crop. So we produce tea in agriculture, as well as tea require a industrial work. Means we, first of all, after we take the leaves of tea, we dry it and we produce tea leaves in the form of tea in the industry, with the help of industry. Same as sugarcane. Sugarcane is also a plantation crop. So first of all, it is an agriculture crop, and for the production of sugar we required sugarcane. So that's why plantation is an interference of agriculture and industry. Plantation, as explained you, because it is a type of commercial farming, so it required capital intensive inputs, help of migrant labors, and done on large farm. All the produce is used as a raw material in the respective industry, like rubber, like sugarcane, like tea, like coffee. All these used as a raw material and processed on these raw material in the industry and convert them into more valuable goods. Tea plantation done in Assam and North Bengal. Coffee plantation in Karnataka. It means these are the important state for these plantation crops. Banana in the southern part of India, rubber in Kerala, bamboo in northeastern India, etc. And the other important plantation crop grown in India. Since the production is mainly for the market, because it's a commercial crop, and well-developed network of transportation and communication connecting the plantation area, processing industry and market is present time. So plantation crop, we discussed the major plantation crop like tea and coffee. Tea. Tea is also, as explained you, is a plantation crop. It is also a beverage crop introduced in India by British. That's why it is a exotic kind of crop or exotic kind of species, because it is not a native. Tea is not a native crop of India. It is brought from other country by the Britishers. That's why it is called as a exotic crop or exotic species. Tea plant grown well in the tropical and subtropical climates with deep and fertile well-drained soil, which should be rich in humus and the organic matter. So these are the geographical factors for the tea. It require fertile land, drained also, rich in humus and organic matter, and the climatic condition, tropical and subtropical climatic condition it required. Tea bushes required warm and moist free climate throughout the year. It required abundant, cheap and skilled labor, because there is a rigorous process of the production of tea in the farms. So that's why it required cheap and abundant labor, but it should be skilled. The processed tea with tea garden to restore its freshness. Major tea producing states, first of all Assam, hills of Darjeeling, Jalpaiguri district of West Bengal, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. India is the leading producer as well as the exporter of tea in the world. First of all, Assam is a stand first in the production of tea. After tea, the second crop it is coffee. Coffee produce about 4% of the world's coffee. Means in India, if you talk about the entire world, so 4% of world's coffee production only in India. Indian coffee is known as the world for its best quality. The Arabica variety initially brought from Yemen, as the tea brought from China by the Britishers, same as the coffee brought from the Yemen in production produced in India. Variety of great demand in the world also. Its cultivation was initially introduced on Baba Budan Hills, and even today Baba Budan Hills are area of Andhra Pradesh. Rest of Nilgiri in Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu are the important state for the cultivation of coffee. Next, horticulture crops. Horticulture also a kind of plantations. Especially in horticulture, there are fruits and vegetables. So large production of fruits and vegetable called as a horticulture. Fruits and vegetable. India is producer of tropical as well as temperate fruits also. Fruit in great demand, mango of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Orange of Nagpur, Chirapunji, bananas of Kerala, Mizoram, lychees and guava of UP and Bihar, pineapple of Meghalaya, grapes of Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. Same as the vegetables, it is an important producer. India is an important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbages, tomatoes, brinjal and potatoes. Rubber. Rubber is another plantation crop. It is an equatorial crop, but under special condition, it is also grown in tropical and subtropical area, because rubber required lots of humid condition. So that's why it is a equatorial crop, but in a special reference or in a special condition, it can grow in tropical and subtropical. It means in Indian conditions also. It require moist, as I explain you, and humid climate with more than 200 centimeter rainfall. Temperature should be above 25 degree Celsius. It is a very important raw material for the industries, mainly grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, and Garo, as you know, Meghalaya, Garo Khasi Jayantia hills are there. So especially in the Garo hills, India ranks 5th among the world in natural rubber producing. As we just see that rubber is a very important for the industry. So consumption of rubber, like in auto tires, cycle tires, tube camels, back foot wears, belts, horses, latex form deep goods, other things. So it's required in so many things. Next are fiber crops. Fiber crops like jute, cotton, hemp, natural silk, these are the major fiber crops grown in India. The first three, like cotton, jute, derived from the crop in soil. Silk is obtained from the cocoon. So it's called as silk rearing, because it generates or it occurs from a worm and fed on green leaves, especially in mulberry. So mulberry, on mulberry leaves, there is a rearing of this silk cocoon, silk worm. And with the help of this, these silkworm form these cocoon. You can see in the picture also. And with the help of these cocoon, we can get the silk. Rearing of silkworm for the production of silk fiber is known as sericulture. As we just discussed, horticulture, production of fruits and vegetable, and rearing of silkworm to get the silk called as sericulture. Cotton. Cotton is a very important thing. It believed that it is original home for the cotton plant. India is the original home for the cotton plant. As you know, in colonial time period, Britishers also brought the raw material, good quality of cotton from here, and they sell the factory production in India. One of the main raw material for the cotton textile industry, India is the third largest producer of cotton in the world. Cotton grew well in drier part of black soil of Deccan Plateau, because cotton required black soil. That's why black soil is also known as black cotton soil, and black soil found in the Peninsular Plateau. So in Deccan Plateau, the most important area for the production of cotton. If you see the climatic condition and geographical factors, so it require high temperature, light rainfall, 210 frost free days, there should not be frost, and bright sunshine for the growth. It is a kharif crop which required 8 to 10 months to mature. Special states for production of cotton: Maharashtra, Gujarat, MP, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana and UP. These are the major cotton producing states. Rest of topic we will discuss in next video. Thank you.